Hello students, welcome to Semester Online Learning Classes. Over here you will get the best platform to upgrade your knowledge and make yourself better. In the previous video I have taught you about nouns, kinds of nouns, and I hope it is clear to everyone. In this video I have uploaded nouns, number and gender. So let's begin with noun, numbers. So nouns in English can be divided into countable noun and uncountable nouns. Countable nouns are nouns that we can count. For example, we can count tree, one tree, two trees, three trees, etc. Right? So tree comes under the category of countable noun. I hope it is clear to everyone. Uncountable nouns are nouns which we cannot count. For example, rain. We cannot say one rain, two rain, or three rain. So rain is uncountable noun. Is it clear? As we can see, countable noun have a singular and plural form. Tree is singular and trees is plural, right? But uncountable nouns have only one singular form and no plural form. Again, I'm repeating, uncountable nouns have only one singular form and no plural form. We cannot say rains. Rains is wrong. We cannot say rains. Okay. With countable noun, we can use a, an, or a number. We can say a pen or 10 pens. We can count pens. So it is a countable noun. With uncountable noun, we cannot use a, an, or a number. For example, we cannot say a rice, two rice. No, it is not possible. It is just rice. Countable noun can use a singular verb or plural verb. For example, the book is old. The books are old. Book is a singular noun, so we are using singular verb. Books is a plural noun, so we are using a plural verb. I hope it is clear to everyone. With uncountable noun, we always use singular verb. For example, sugar is sweet. Sugar is uncountable, so we have to use a singular verb, is. Another example, the weather here is great. Weather over here is again uncountable noun. So we have to use singular verb, that is. I hope this is clear to everyone, right? Now in this slide, what you have to understand is abstract ideas are uncountable nouns. Because as we have studied, abstract ideas have no physical existence. They refer to ideas, emotions, and concepts that you cannot see or touch, right? For example, love. Love is uncountable noun. You cannot touch it. You cannot hear love. Love is uncountable noun. You cannot count it. You cannot say two love or five love. No, that is wrong. Some examples are love, freedom, education, luck, help, beauty, music. In the example given below, money can't buy love. So love over here is uncountable noun. We like to experience happiness. Again, happiness, uncountable noun. This education is priceless. Education over here is uncountable noun. Next, come to slide 4. Over here you will know about liquid and gases. Liquid and gases are generally uncountable nouns. For example, milk. You cannot count milk. You cannot count milk. Why? Because it is uncountable noun. You can count the container in which it is kept. For example, 2 bottles of milk. Here, you are counting the container of the milk. And in this case, you are counting the bottles and not the milk. Right? So, some more examples of liquid and gases that are uncountable are water, milk, wine, oil, coffee, rain, soup, air, smoke, blood, juice, fog, and so on, right? One more thing which you have to understand over here is, sometimes you will hear people say a coffee or two coffees. Why is a number used if coffee is supposed to be uncountable noun? The fact is, they are asking for a cup of coffee, a cup, or two cups of coffee, two cups. Again, you are counting the cups in which coffee comes in and not the coffee itself. So it is just a short way of asking for. Like we generally say, please give me one glass of water. That is wrong. We cannot use one glass of water. We have to say, please give me a glass of water. A will be used over there instead of using one. That is a wrong sentence. Okay. I hope this is clear to everyone. Things that are made up of smaller parts, though, is considered as a whole. For example, sugar. Sugar consists of many grains of sugar, though it is considered as a whole thing. You cannot count sugar. If you are really bored, then you can count the individually grains of sugar. But again, you are counting the number of grains and not sugar itself, right? Because many of the students ask me, ma'am, we can count sugar. No, you cannot count sugar. You are counting the grain. You are not counting the sugar. So you have to understand that thing. So sugar is uncountable. If you count, you can count the teaspoon of sugar. But again, you are counting the number of teaspoon used, not the sugar. Some examples are like rice, salt, sand, flour, dirt, dust, traffic, grass, etc. Now, nouns that say something is made up of, these are normally uncountable nouns. Generally, you can say material nouns. Some examples are like wood, glass, paper, ice, gold, silver, iron, cotton, wool, steel, etc. For example, you cannot count gold. You can count bars of gold, but again, you are counting bars of gold and not gold itself. Again, one more thing which you have to keep in mind is, with gold, we use singular verb. That is why over here in this example, I have used gold is expensive. With gold, I am using singular verb, that is, because gold is uncountable noun. Is it clear? As we have seen, some food are uncountable. Usually food that is need to be cut or eaten in smaller pieces. Some examples are like, you can say bread, fish, cheese, chocolate, meat, bacon, food, ham. For example, bread is uncountable noun. You cannot count bread. You can count slices of bread, not the bread. Same is with loaves of bread. We don't say breads. That also you have to keep in mind. Because I have already told you that uncountable nouns, they don't have plural form. So you cannot say breads, right? Be careful with the following uncountable nouns as they may be considered countable in other languages. Right? For example, money. Now you may be thinking, what, money is uncountable noun? Really, money is uncountable noun? Yes, but we can count money. So the answer to this question is, you can count coins. You can count dollars, $1, $2, $3, but you cannot say one money, two money, three money, etc. So that is why money is uncountable noun. Other examples are like furniture, work, news, information, advice, luggage, money, etc. So these come These nouns comes under the category of uncountable nouns. Just for your knowledge, I'm taking few sentences. Where we are means uncertain that whether this noun is considered as countable noun or uncountable noun. So listen to these sentences very carefully, right? For comparison purpose. Like if I say, I'm looking for a job. So job over here is what? Countable noun. But if I'm saying, I'm looking for work. So work over here will be uncountable noun. If I'm saying, what a beautiful view. So view over here is, view is countable. So view over here is a countable noun. But if I'm saying, what beautiful scenery. So scenery over here is uncountable. It's a nice day today. Day again over here is countable. You can count na, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. But if I'm saying, it's nice weather today. Weather over here is uncountable noun. We had a lot of bags and suitcases. So bags and suitcases you can count. So it comes under the category of countable noun. But if I'm saying we had a lot of luggage. So luggage is uncountable noun. These chairs are mine. Again, chairs over here is countable noun. This furniture is mine. Furniture. So furniture over here is uncountable noun. It was a good suggestion. Suggestion, countable noun. It was good advice. Advice, again, uncountable noun. So you have to keep these sentences in mind when you are solving countable and uncountable noun. I hope I'm clear to everyone. Now in this slide, what you have to understand is that which quantifiers are used with countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Like with countable nouns, you use few, a few, not many. And with uncountable nouns, you use little, a little, not much. And I have made one note over there. No, none, a lot of, most, all is used with both countable and uncountable noun. Now the question arises, how to use much and many? As I told you, much is used with uncountable nouns and many is used with uncountable nouns, right? And both these words means a lot of or lots of, or you can say a large quantity of something, right? So much and many are mainly used in negative sentences and questions. Much is used with uncountable nouns, I have told you already. Many is used with plural countable nouns. Again, I'm repeating, with plural countable nouns. Remember this and keep this in mind. Like for example, if I'm saying, I don't have much time. So over here with time, you are using much. He doesn't need much money. With again, money, you are using much. Does it use much electricity? Again, you are using much with uncountable noun, that is electricity. In case of many, there aren't many chairs in the room. Many chairs. You can count chairs, right? So that is why you are using many. That is with plural countable noun. Chairs and not chair. I don't have many friends. Many friends. You can count friends, right? Do you think many people will go? Many people. Again, many is used with plural countable noun. And as I already told you, a lot of is used with both countable nouns and uncountable nouns, right? So with affirmative sentences, we prefer a lot of instead of much or many. Like for example, you can say, I need a lot of coffee. So over here, a lot of is used with uncountable nouns, right? There is a lot of traffic today. A lot of, again, used with uncountable noun. Next example can be with the plural countable nouns, like she has a lot of friends, a lot of friends. Or you can say she has lots of friends. Both are correct. There are a lot of cars on the street. A lot of cars. Again, you're using a lot of with plural countable nouns. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now let's try to understand another set of quantifiers, that is few, a few, little and a little. Both denotes a small quantity, or you can say a small amount. Like few, as I already told you, few is used with plural countable nouns, which means not many, or you can say not enough, or you can say nearly no. A few is used with plural countable nouns, which means some, a small amount. Again, little is used with uncountable nouns, and the meaning of little denotes that not much, not enough, nearly no. And a little is used with uncountable nouns, which means some, or you can say a small amount. Now let's take few examples. As I told you, few means not many. So few normally conveys a negative idea. So if I say, he has few good friends. So a negative idea is portraying over here, means not enough, few good friends, not enough. Another example can be, few people went to the concert. So few people means again not enough. There are few honest politicians, few honest, again not many, conveying a negative idea. Now come to little. Little, as I told you, it means not much. Little normally conveys a negative idea. For example, there was little time to finish it. There was little time to finish it. So over here, it is portraying a negative idea. Nearly no time was left. Another example can be, he has little patience with others. Or another example can be, they have little money to spend. So you can say not much. Now come to a few. A few means some, a small amount. Few conveys a negative idea, but a few conveys a positive idea. So if I say he has a few friends that will help. So over here I'm talking about a positive idea. That is a small amount of friend he is having, right? Or I say, I have a few days off next month. So I'm conveying a positive idea. She has won a few awards. A few. Again, conveying a positive idea. Then come to a little. A little means again some, a small amount. But a little normally conveys a positive idea. Like if I say, I have a little milk, you can use positive idea, a small amount. I'm having a little milk. Little bit is there. She has a little time to relax now. I have earned a little extra money. So it is conveying a positive idea. I hope all the quantifiers are clear to you. A few, few, little, where to use what. Now this is just a recap of whatever we have learned. I have just made a note which you have to see, that is, we can make uncountable nouns countable by adding partitive nouns to them. For example, a bar of chocolate, chocolate, furniture, butter, sugar, soap, advice, bread, water, these are all what? These are uncountable nouns. But if we want to make them, or we want to convert them into countable nouns, we have to add certain number over there. That is why I have written a bar of chocolate, four pieces of furniture, a tub of butter, a spoon of sugar, a bar of soap, a piece of advice, a loaf of bread, a slice of bread, a glass of water.